Hey guys, Dylan from the Geek Duo here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to Shadowhunters Season 2, Episode 13, titled Those of Demon Blood. The sudden deaths of several Shadowhunters forces the Institute's leader to consider a controversial defense against a violent downworld of revolt. So, I didn't touch on this in the breakdown at the end of the last reaction, mainly because I'd forgotten it by that point, but what the hell was the plot of a downworlder revolt in the last episode? Like, it was part of the synopsis and everything, the possible downworlder uprising, yet there was nothing in the actual episode about that. The only downloader we got was Raphael and that, and they went after Simon for a personal reason, and then found out that he was a Daylighter. Like, was that the downloader uprising? So, considering that's also a part of this synopsis, is it actually going to be relevant to this episode? Is it not going to happen again? But, the controversial, defense is probably going to be closing the Institute or more policing. It's going to be one of those two. It's not going to work out well for them, but it's probably going to be one of those two. We'll find out in 3, 2, 1. Yeah, I forget if I mentioned this in the last episode, but Raphael's reaction to Simon being a Daylighter in the book was to tell him to stay as far away from the rest of the vampires as possible, even though up until that point he'd been trying to get Simon into the clan. And that's what I meant by it's been very different, because he'd already brought Simon in the show before it happened. And she's drinking. with a rune on it. That's interesting. I mean, you remove the rune, you remove its effects, so is that like a progressive thing in battle, or is that done after the death? That's a new name. Really, you think? Interesting. Because in the book, the myth was that the Daylighter would bring dark times for the Night Children. I mean, you're not wrong, that is. Shouldn't really. Of course you would think the ex circle member. Interesting, because stubbornness is a Herondale trait. Excuse me. It could well be that it's none of them and it's just leading. It's a mis could well be a misdirection. Cause how exactly are they gonna pin it on a warlock? Not going to explain how they know. I mean, it's as old as the Fairchilds, so. So I need some DNA. All right. Yeah, Jewish. I can see why it'd be an issue. Yeah, I can see why Simon would have an issue. If you're training, you do need breakfast. This is a plot point from, from the sequel series. You don't want to get on your grandmother's bad side, because you now actually have family. I mean, technically, going off of what I said before I let that scene play out, is this sort of like a plot point from the sequel series? It wasn't so much tracking, it was registration of all Downworlders. But remember, this came out before that series started, so. No, they're really not. Do your own thing, Jace. Mean, you're not wrong. Well, I mean, she's not wrong, I should say. Spoils were a thing in the up until the 1800s. I wonder, is it gonna be Melion? Yes. Yes, it is. Vampire could well be Camille. She's captured by the Clave, but who says she hasn't escaped? Do that. No. He's not disputing. This is a smug look on Simon's face. Is it going to actually be Melion or? Keep him with you, Isabel. And what did I say? Keep him with you. Like, that was obviously going to happen. Hey, kid, you wanted to go out in the field? Guess what? Now you have to deal with some sick shit. Haley? Does Max even have any runes for you? Other than the Enkeli, yeah. Still should be the Voyance rune on the back of his hand, but they don't really do that. Shouldn't have taken her brother. Had you been found with anyone else, she may have just imprisoned you, but No, the Institute. I mean, it can abdicate at any time. Usually it needs an official clave to appoint the next head, but a wee bit more popular than the normal dive bars you play at. Why do I have a feeling Maya's track is gonna, come back up in the future? Is this actually him or? Even was not expecting Raphael to be there. Okay, I guess not. I was wondering if that's where this was going, but huh. Right. So that is a major departure from Maya in the book, because Jace reminds her too much of her brother for that to ever happen. That's part of the reason she doesn't like Jace. Is because, I don't know if this is going to come up in the book. This was in the show, I mean. This was revealed through Maya narrated chapters in the books where her brother, perfect boy, loved by everyone, handsome as shit, could do no wrong in the eyes of the people around him. Everyone loved him both as a person and because of his looks, which is what she views Jace as. The problem is, her brother was also a psychopath who would just harm her for no reason, do all this sick shit, and eventually he died. And then she went through this massive wreck because of the way her brother treated her, she didn't feel bad that he died. So she thought she was a bad person, got into a bad headspace, then just progressively more people through her life of similar, like, viewed by people, both handsome, loved by everyone, but have a darkness, including the person who turned her boyfriend at the time, because he got turned, he went through all the new wolf things, like the change in personality, the aggression and everything. She broke up with him. He saw her out with another guy. He then lost control, turned into a wolf. And that was the night that he attacked her and turned her into a wolf. That is, so just compounding and compounding all those kinds of people. So Bookmire would never even think about doing that with Jace. And I did, when he came and to the behind the Hunter's Moon, as soon as that scene started, I thought, is this where that's going? Turns out yes it is. And yeah, it's just weird decision to have that, considering it is such a departure from the character in the book. Anyway, at least this episode actually did touch upon all the parts of the synopsis. I was correct in both the fact that I said a lockout from the Institute and stricter policing. Well, I did not expect it to go that far in terms of its policing. I was correct. And I was also correct in it being a diversion to make it look as though it is a full downworld revolt, but it's actually only one group. I didn't think it was going to be a downworld at all. I thought it was going to be like a mundane with a site, which haven't really dealt with any of those, have we? That it was either going to be a mundane with the site, or it was going to be a, like, greater demon, at least one with more intelligence, was going to be a, like, Dark Shadow Hunter. I didn't think it was going to actually be a downworlder. But, no, it was Kaylee, something Willow, I think her name is. Kaylee White Willow. So I would have guessed right had I actually said that, but I second guessed myself and yeah. But again, that's a character that's meant to survive to at least book 3. No, she survives to book 6. I'm pretty sure she dies in the sequel series, but She definitely in book six. So, interesting. She was actually a, I guess, was she a waitress or a barmaid? I can't quite remember. The book version of this store, it was actually, in the book, they all went to like a Chinese restaurant that was Downworlder run and everything. Like, you could get Downworlder meals and that. They did serve Shadowhunters. And Kaylee was introduced there. Hunter's Moon didn't come until later, but... yeah, so... surprised to see that... A, she was named in this episode, because we've seen that actress before, and I don't think we actually got the character's name. And B, I'm surprised they turned her into the antagonist of this. But I guess it does make sense. She was a morally grey, as all fair folk are, but... yeah. Anyway, I'm interested to see where this could be going, because, as I said, I occasionally look ahead at the synopsises, and several more of future episodes still talk about this Downworlder revolt. So, like, obviously there's still bad blood between everything that happened with the Mortal Sword and now this added onto it, but it does seem like it's pretty cut and dry. This was the end of it. And again, they did speculate that Kaylee was working with people for reasons other than just the Mortal Sword, so... who knows? Anyway, I'm gonna end this one here. I'll catch you in the next one.